wait for a couple people to get on here, man, before we go ahead and talk about today's topic, man. Been doing my research a little bit, y'all. And for those who don't know, today I'm gonna tell y'all about the Flintstone. All right? You see all these companies out here doing all this landscaping in and you know, working their ass off and everything, doing as much as they can, you know, to cut your grass and trim your trees, the whole nine, right? I want to talk about the Flintstone lawnmower. It is the lawnmower that we use in Department of Corrections, okay? If y'all don't know what the Flintstone is, y'all go check it out, all right? But I'm going to break it down to y'all a little bit. I've been doing my research or whatnot. I've been reading up on it, and this is what it looks like right here. For those who do not know, that is what the Flintstone looks like. It is a push mower, all right? I'm going to tell y'all some stories and break it down to y'all about this push mower, all right? This Flintstone is what it's called. Here we are, we're about to hit 2020. And the system has us cutting grass with the first lawnmower that was actually invented August 31st, 1830. That's exactly when it was invented. And it's the first lawnmower. It isn't just a push lawnmower. Department of Corrections has us in there cutting grass with the Flintstone. All right? You know? And the way it works is basically, you know, you just run with it. And as you run, the faster you run, appreciate that, man, the faster you run, it cuts the blades. There's a blade in front of it, a long spiral blade, and the faster you run with it, it cuts. So I'm gonna tell y'all about when I was at Calhoun and they used to try to get us to cut grass with that. They do this every day. I appreciate the donation, man. They do this every day. They make you stand in four groups, like a baseball field. You got home, first, second, third. That's what they do when they're gonna attack a section with this damn Flintstone. They'll have you standing in four groups, and someone grabs the Flintstone, takes off running towards one group. So y'all are standing like a square. Takes off running towards the group, and then someone out of that group grabs it and runs to the other group with it. And then someone out of that group grabs it and does the same thing all the way around. And they keep doing it and taking turns until your section goes from being this big of the grass until you done ran in so many circles that it gets rid of it all. Now, they're literally slaving people day to day in there with this Flintstone. I'll say it again. Look at when this lawnmower came out, and this is what they have you using in the chain gang. Look at this. It came out August 31st, 1830. And we're in 2020. All right. It says right here, the first lawnmower was invented by Edward Budding in 1830, just outside Stroud in England. Budding's mower was designed primarily to cut grass on sports grounds and extensive gardens. The way it works in the Department of Corrections when it comes down to cutting that grass with that damn Flintstone, every day they got you cutting the same shit. You start at the beginning of the compound, and they got you cutting all the area, and then throughout the week, you're making your way farther and farther around the compound, and you're just doing it in circles. They do it just, you know, to teach you discipline, I guess. But I'm going to tell y'all a story about, I was walking the chow one time, and, you know, you got officers that standing out there and stuff, and officers just to pick on you and stuff, you know, bet that up, Will. But, yeah, so, you got officers that stand around the compound and they'll literally single people out and pick people out and try people and tell you go grab a Flintstone. They literally have the Flintstone sitting there by the center gate and they think that they're just going to throw your ass on a Flintstone. You could be in Crocs. You could be in your new brand new shoes. You could be in your clean ass boots. You could be in whatever. Shower slides. You're not supposed to walk around the compound in shower slides, but some people do it. And they're going to tell your ass to go out there and push that Flintstone. Well, I remember one time I was walking the chow, and I got into it with the officer or whatever, because there's a line that walks everywhere through the compound. The inmate's supposed to be on the little side of the line. So you have a lane this big, and then the officers have a whole huge sidewalk. You know, they try to keep you in lane. You literally have a walk area about this wide. You know, so I crossed the line. I wasn't walking inside my spot where the inmate's supposed to be. And this officer had a bunch of dip in his mouth and everything. He walks up. He like, go grab one of them Flintstones. This and that, this and that. You ain't going to chow. I'm like, I ain't going to chow. I'm like, man, I ain't grabbing no damn Flintstone. He like, oh, you better grab a Flintstone. Spits on the ground. Yo, you better grab that Flintstone right now if you know what's good for you. I guess y'all know, I didn't grab the Flintstone. I went to confinement. They cuffed me. They took me to confinement. All because I didn't want to use a damn lawnmower that came out in 1830. And this has happened on a day-to-day basis. And if I'm not mistaken, I think it was chicken day. I damn sure wasn't finna miss child cutting no damn grass on chicken day. You know? So It just blows my mind, you know. They're supposed to, you know. Now the outside squads, the ones that work outside the gate, they don't use these Flintstones. They got actual lawnmowers and shit like that. But inside the compound, you know, they have your ass running around with a Flintstone from back in the day. You might be on DR squad. Some camps have DR squad. And that's to where when you get in trouble and shit, they put you in the DR squad. That's where you got to go around. All y'all done been in trouble. It kind of avoids you from going to confinement. They sentence you to DR squad. And you'll see the little squad going on. Like, we'll all be sitting there at rec or hitting canteen window. And you'll look over and you'll see the DR squad. There they go walking across the compound with this damn lawnmower. You know? So to me, I just find it kind of crazy because who the hell wants to cut the grass with that? That's what I mean. They make it hard for you to do your time, you know? And you see people every day going to jail refusing to use that. That shit literally came out in 1830. It says it's the first lawnmower invented. You know, they have so much money, they could have been upgraded. But they don't, you know? So I want to introduce y'all to the Flintstone. Anyone who's been to prison probably's done pushed it and tested it. Don't get me wrong, I pushed it a couple times, you know, but I wasn't having it that day about chow. But there's been a couple times I pushed it, you know, because I heard about the Flintstone before I even went to prison. So, you know, everything that you hear, you're going to want to test it, you know, and stuff like that. So I tested the Flintstone out and you pushing it, it ain't cutting. It's not, it's just, you literally have to run with that Flintstone. So, like, you'll literally be sitting there in the dorm and look out the window, and you'll see an inmate out there running in squares by himself, you know, till about dark time, till the officer says, go inside. You know, like, it's crazy. And, like I said, as much money as they bring in, I'm just surprised. I didn't know it was the first lawnmower ever. I literally just found this out. I knew it was a Flintstone. It was an old one. I just didn't know that it was the first one ever. I did not know that. So that's something new to me also. And it's just crazy because, like, you know, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna click on here and I'm gonna see if they have a video that I could show y'all. You know, it's just crazy. Like, I can't believe, like, what they actually have inmates out there doing. You know? I hope y'all like that merchandise I put out. You know, that's just my first batch. I'm gonna have more. That's just my first batch. Appreciate all the donations. I'm trying to, anybody ever go to prison, they're going to try to have you push this damn Flintstone, man. And, you know, it's just ridiculous. Which, don't get me wrong, when you run with it, it cuts it. It's a very good lawnmower, which I call it a grass cutter. It's a very good grass cutter. It does work, you know, but it's just the, what they got you in there doing. You know, I'd be damn, man. I wouldn't use that. If that's the only thing I had on the streets, I would not use that, you know? And it's just crazy to me because who the hell is supplying these? Because they literally have hundreds of them at each camp. It ain't like they just have one or two of them somewhere I seen. Every camp you go to, they literally have these damn Flintstones. And, you know, y'all drop some comments or whatever. I'm going to start doing every Friday. Every Friday, I'm going to do questions and answers. So on Fridays, I'll be going live or whatever. I'm going to stop going live as much as I've been. You know, unless y'all think that's better than me uploading videos. But every Friday, I think I'm going to start doing questions and answers and stuff like that. You know? And it's just crazy to me because, like...
This was my phone before I called you.
You know, you can't have too many...
This was my phone before I called you.
You don't want to have too many... you don't want to have too many, like, live streams, I guess. So... I'm going to go ahead and start uploading some videos. I believe my next one after this, I'm going to go ahead and speak on, I guess I'll speak on my next video. I guess it's a surprise, really. I can't really say what I'm going to speak on. It'll have to be something different. But I appreciate everybody who's been rocking with me and everyone who's been, you know, tuned in or whatever. And, you know, all the people out there, whatever, that's trolling me, like, you know, hating, wanting me to say stuff so they blow up and everything. It ain't gonna happen, you know. All of a sudden, everybody's been locked up with K-Frog. Now everybody's saying they've been locked up with me. You feel me? That's funny. But anyways, you know, this video right here was specifically about the Flintstone. You know, and I pray that nobody, you know, knock on wood... That nobody has to go there and experience that Flintstone. Because for some reason, especially in the Panhandle, Bluntstown, Calhoun, them police officers love to have you out there pushing that Flintstone. And it doesn't make no sense. Like what it is they literally get out of it. But they literally, like, they get an excitement out of it. You know what I'm saying? Did they fight each other with the Flintstone? Nah, not really. But, it's a legit, like, mission. When I say a mission, I mean a mission. Everything you see that a lawnmower does for you, nowadays, you gotta do that yourself with this damn Flintstone. And you know, nowadays they even have upgraded Flintstones. Ones that actually have a motor. Not even a motor, but it'll have an electric belt that moves for it. You know? And it's just crazy because like a lot of people, you know, it's like, look, let's see if I can show y'all this, what this blade looks like on these Flintstones right here. Okay, this one's kind of a little more souped up looking. But as you see, that is the blade right there. Look at that. That's the blade. And when you run, that blade cuts the grass. But you literally have to run for it to cut. Like... It just blows my mind, man. Like, you know, They got dudes out there. I seen a dude go to jail because he just came from Vizzo. So, you know, he was crispy clean, had his nice good old, you know, blues on or whatever and everything. He fresh shoes on, and he got into it because when you come back, you got to stop at center gate and stand in line. Even if there ain't a line, you got to stand there until the officer in center gate says, like that. Literally, you don't just walk back to your dorm. Like, it's kind of like a process everywhere you go. Through a gate, stand by the gate, and this and that, you know? To the point to where when I came home, I was used to people opening the doors for me. I would walk, I'd get out the car with people and go to the gas station and stand there, and they'd open, and then I'd walk in. Like, you adapt to it. They don't want you touching their doors. And the man came back from Vizzo, so while he was standing at center gate, the officer just kept him there. It starts raining. So he's like, hey, Sarge, man, they, so, you know, nobody wants to get their fresh blues messed up and they're all wet and their shoes and shit. So he got into it with the officer, and the officer grabbed the Flintstone and brought it over there and was trying to tell him to go out there and cut the grass. And we were all looking out our window and all looking because we had bar windows with like an actual slide up window through the bars, you know. And I remember we were looking like this at Calhoun. We were looking and he was out there, this and that, this and that. Next thing you know, you see them come, they arrest them, they cuff them up. He was like, man, you got me fucked up. You think I'm finna sit here and cut this grass with these fresh shoes on? Yeah, he went to confinement. You know, he kept his shoes clean and everything, all that. But they just took all that if they didn't even put it back in his property, you know? But they literally get away with so much. Like, they'll have you out there, like I said, till it's about to get dark out, you know? And it's just crazy because, you know, they get a rouse of it, especially in the panhandle, like I said. Now, down south, we didn't see them Flintstones like that. You know, down south, they didn't really cut the grass right there, like in the inside of the compound. But that Flintstone, they have it all the camps. Y'all could do your research and look it up. As I just showed y'all, it came out in 1830. And that is the exact lawnmower that they have you cutting these compounds with. The very first lawnmower invented. Shit just blew my mind. Wasn't even expecting that in this video. You know? But, comments are moving so fast. I can't really catch on to them. But yeah, man. Like I said, y'all go ahead and follow me on Instagram. It's kfraw_100. You know, I respond to everybody that writes me. You know, y'all can drop your ideas of what y'all want to see. You know, and then you know, I'll come out with them. I'll make the videos. Appreciate that, FinTech. You know, I got that merch now. Y'all look in the description. Y'all will see that merchandise so y'all can see what K-Frog TV came out with. It's called Unaffiliated. I dropped that due to the fact that I don't gangbang, and I didn't gangbang, so I dropped Unaffiliated. You know, just to, as a reminder to everyone, to let everyone know that you can do it without gangbanging. See what I'm saying? So it's called Unaffiliated. Unaffiliated gear, and then this is just my first batch or whatever. I'm gonna have plenty more coming out. And y'all just stay tuned in or whatnot. Look at this damn thing. Look at that. Look at the Flintstone, man. Look at this. It's crazy. But that new merch coming out, I'm gonna be putting some songs up. Also, I got some songs coming. What I'm going to start doing is I'm going to start doing super chats, and then to where I feel like whoever donates the most on a super chat, I'm going to give them a big shout out in my next videos. That's what I'm going to start doing. You know, y'all just check the link in the description. Y'all stay tuned in. And I might put another video out tonight. I won't be live, but I might put another video out tonight. You know, just to appreciate that, Prospector. Get a beverage on you. That real now. Hell yeah. Oh, I just want to release this information too. Today I finally finalized volume 3 of K4ALL TV, but like I said, I'm just waiting to put it out there. I might put a screenshot of it up later, like just a screenshot to show. I think it's like 15 minutes long or something like that. I might put a screenshot up later for y'all to see that it is finalized. I finalized it today. I'm just waiting to drop it. I have a couple things I got to take care of. So, what tattoo hurt the most in the pen? It'd have to be one right here I got. I got half my nipple tattooed. I have a skull right here. And the skull I have, like, looks like he's biting my nipple. I got half my whole nipple tattooed all the way. And that shit right there killed me. I'm gonna talk about my tattoos in another video, too. That's a video I wanted to bring out to y'all. But this video right here was specifically about the lawnmower I was talking about, the Flintstone. And it's just crazy to me. Like I said, I wasn't expecting it to be that damn. I had no idea that it was literally that old. I didn't know that it was the first lawnmower ever, and this is the one that they have us using in prison. It literally is just, it's just crazy. I'm gonna show y'all again what the Flintstone looks like. Look at that, man. That's the Flintstone, man. See it? The Flintstone, man. It's the one thing you want to stay away from if you go to prison. Ain't nothing but blood, sweat, and tears and years behind these Flintstones. Straight up. Blood, sweat, tears, and years behind these Flintstones, man. But all right, y'all. I'm not going to take up too much of y'all's time or whatever. I appreciate all the donations. Y'all check out the merchandise. I just wanted to speak on the Flintstone. And that's it. Until I see y'all next time or whatever. I might drop another video later tonight. This was just a little live real quick so I could chop it up with y'all. Let y'all know I got merchandise out there. Follow me on Instagram, K4ALL_100. And everything's in the description. My PayPal, my Cash App, whatever it is. Y'all support the channel. More things are coming. And I appreciate everyone that supported already. All right? This K4ALL, man. It's over with. I'm going to holler at y'all.